Hello everyone and welcome to this video tutorial on how to apply the law on trespass to land to a tort scenario. In this tutorial we're going to be looking at a mini scenario on trespass to land and looking at how you would use that IDEA structure, the IDEA EA structure, to get a really nice answer to this question. Let's start by looking at the scenario that we've got here. So the situation is that Aidan and Eddie own neighbouring detached houses. Eddie says he's happy for Aidan to come onto his land to replace a fence. Aidan takes the fence down and stacks it on Eddie's front garden. Aidan then digs a trench 50 centimetres wide for foundations for the wall, filling it with concrete. Half of the trench is actually in Eddie's garden. Aidan never builds the wall, but he leaves the fence panels on Eddie's garden. So you're being asked to advise Eddie, and obviously this is trespass to land, and the indications here that it's trespass to land are obviously that there are things on the land and under the land, and that's quite typical. In trespass scenarios, you often see things flying over someone's property or trenches under the garden. Things hanging over fences, typical trespass to land scenarios. Now, before we highlight this, identifying the key issues in the scenario, it's useful to just remind ourselves of what the law on trespass to land is. So if I just switch back to our summary slide then on trespass to land, this is quite a straightforward tort. There aren't many requirements that need to be proven. Just a quick reminder for you that you've got to have direct interference with the land. It must be voluntary. There's no need for the person to be aware that they're trespassing because it's actionable per se. Equally, there's no need for harm or loss. That's what that means, actionable per se, meaning in and of itself. And that you can have trespass above the land, someone, I don't know, flying a drone over your house, or below the land if someone's digging under your property, and we've got the key cases there. We do have defences to trespass, so look out for police. We'll typically have a defence to trespass to land under the Police and Criminal Evidence Act. Consent might have been given, and sometimes that'll crop up in your scenario that one character gives some consent to the other person, but maybe they go beyond that permission. And also necessity from the case of Rigby. So now we've reminded ourselves of what we're looking for, let's have a look at what the issues are for Aidan and Eddie. Always, we're going to go through and highlight the issues as they appear in the scenario. So we're told that Aidan and Eddie are owning neighbouring detached houses. Eddie says he's happy for Aidan to come onto his land to replace a fence. Now that stands out to me immediately, so I'm going to highlight that. He's happy for Aidan to come onto his land. So that's looking like the defence of consent. Aidan takes the fence down and stacks it on Eddie's front garden. So there was no permission given for that. And the fact that it's stacked on the front garden can be a trespass to land. Aidan then digs a trench 50 centimetres wide. So that's making me think trespass below the ground. Half of the trench is actually in Eddie's garden, yep, so we can see it's in Eddie's property. Aidan never builds the wall, but he leaves the fence panels on Eddie's garden. Okay, so there are issues. So it's looking quite nice and straightforward. Before we jump in and try and write an answer to it, let's remind ourselves of the structure that we always use for using a scenario. So we're going to use IDEA, but we're going to use the EA structure. Now, if you prefer just standard IDEA, okay, you don't feel comfortable with EA IDEA, that's fine. But trespass to land just lends itself really nicely to using this EA structure. So don't worry if you've forgotten what EA is, I'm going to go through that now. So as always, we start by identifying who our defendant is and what they might be liable in. So in this case, Aidan might be liable in trespass to land for all the things that he's done to Eddie's garden. We're going to define trespass to land. So trespass requires a voluntary direct interference with land, and it's actionable per se. And then I'm going into my explain, but I'm going to explain, apply, explain, apply, explain, apply. That's why it's called the EA idea, because I'm going EA, EA throughout. So firstly, you would explain that there must be a direct interference with the land using Southport and Esso, and then apply it to the situation. Explain that it can be above or below the land using Bernstein and sky views, and apply it. Explain voluntary interference and apply it. Okay, and do that throughout. And this particular structure works really well for trespass. It has the bonus as well. If you did run out of time in the exam, if you'd done the standard idea, a big chunky E, and then all of your application at the very end, you would have missed out on all your AO2 application points. So by doing it this way, you are balancing out your marks. And if you run out of time, at least you'll have got some AO2. On this slide here, I've got a bullet point answer to Aidan and Eddie. You can ignore the red ones. They're just a rough mark scheme for if we were using this in class. So I've identified that Aidan might be liable in trespass to land. I've defined my requirements for trespass to land in my D, that it's direct interference, voluntary, no need for awareness, no need for harm or loss. And then I've used two different coloured fonts so that you can see the nice balance in my answer. So with my E, I've done it in black font, and then my case is in purple. So I've explained direct interference, I've then applied it. I've explained voluntary interference, I've then applied it. I've explained no need for awareness, I've applied it. And that's why you're getting that nice black, green, black, green, black, green throughout. And what that really means is I'm getting AO1, AO2, AO1, AO2. So the examiner's confident that I'm showing both of those skills that we're looking for on this question. So there were lots of issues in that scenario, but you can see here how I've tackled it. So once I've explained direct interference, I've applied that Aidan comes onto the land, he puts a fence on the garden and he digs a trench, and all of those incidents are a direct interference. Yeah, it's not happened indirectly. It's not like in Southport Corporation where some petrol travelled a long way before it ended up on someone's garden. This was directly placed onto Eddie's land, so it meets that requirement. Has to be voluntary, Stone and Smith. And you can see that Aidan meets this requirement because all of his actions are voluntary. It's not like he's been forced to do any of those things. He's not being thrown onto the land. There's no need for awareness, Conway. And I've made the point here that Aidan might not be aware that he's trespassing when he's doing some of those actions. He might think that he has consent for everything because he did ask Eddie the question in the beginning. However, there's no need for awareness for it to be a trespass. I've explained we don't need any harm or loss, that it's actionable per se. And that's relevant here because you can make the point that, okay, Eddie hasn't suffered any harm or loss. His main upset is that there's some fences on his garden, but that's still a trespass to land. It's actionable per se. I've then explained the rules on above or below the land using the cases. And I've pointed out that when Aidan digs a trench, this is a trespass, even though it's below the ground. And you could talk about how deep below the land the courts have discussed there to be a trespass. And remember in the case on that, they said that basically you own beneath the ground up until the point where the heat and the pressure from the core of the earth renders any discussion on it moot. So we'll be happy that however deep this trench is, it's not going to be deeper than we've seen in the cases. So it's going to meet that requirement. I've then explained the different defences to trespass with my cases. And then I've pointed out that there is a defence for Aidan when he comes onto the land in the first place because he had consent for that from Eddie. But all the other things he's done, the digging the trench, putting the fences on the land, is a trespass, and that's actionable. So hopefully you can see from that that the EA structure just works really nicely for trespass to land. The other bonus is you don't forget to apply anything, because sometimes if you do a chunky E and then a chunky A, in your A you've forgotten one of the things that you've explained, you forget to apply it. But here if you explain it and then immediately apply it, you're not going to miss anything out. So trespass to land, quite nice, quite straightforward to do on a scenario. So I hope you found this little tutorial helpful on that.